Perched on the Pacific Ocean, Sydney has long been one of the world's most iconic cities. Known as the birthplace of surfing in Australia and renowned for its picturesque harbour, rocky headlands and stunning beaches, Sydney's population has pushed past 5 million people in the last few decades, and due to human impacts, an entire marine ecosystem was lost along the way. But there is change happening under the waves. Something is coming back.
Crayweed only really thrives wherever there's big waves. And wherever there's big waves, of course, there are surfers. My name is Adriana Verges, and I'm a professor in marine ecology at UNSW Sydney and the Sydney Institute of Marine Science. Crayweed is one of our most important seaweeds here along the east coast of Australia. It makes incredibly beautiful, lush, super productive underwater forests. And these forests support biodiversity, hundreds of species. It supports our two most valuable fisheries in the whole of Australia, which are the rock lobster and abalone. That's what we gain when we bring crayweed back. Plus, it's also really beautiful. And, you know, it's rewilding our coastlines to what they used to be.
There were some records of it in many places around Sydney, but all those records dated from before sort of like the 1980s. And then after that, it was gone.
The main reason for the disappearance was water quality. You know, people remember going to Bondi and surfing right next to what they call the Bondi cigars.
Talking about the sewer system. From our homes, offices and factories, it quietly flows on its journey, removing the poo, the pee and the putrid from our homes and workplaces.
But what's really interesting is where it goes when it comes out.
At Pipeline, Tom Carroll became the man.
My name's Tom Carroll and I'm from the northern beaches of Sydney. You know, through the 80s, there was only primary treatment to sewage pouring out off North Head, and as soon as we get a big rain and a southerly wind, we'd have this raw sewage coming out and just flowing straight into the lineup. And we'd be competing there and practicing and so on at Manly. And very shortly after the surf, you'd start to feel a rawness in the throat. And then a couple of hours later, you'd be spitting sort of green stuff out through your sinus.
In the early 90s, the government decided to fix the issue of poor water qualities.
So we thought, well, if the water quality is better, can we try and bring these species back? Can we get them to survive? Can we get them to reproduce? And we found that yes, with a little bit of help, crayweed could be brought back into the Sydney region.
Hey, my name is Tom Hobbs. I represent SeaTrees in Australia. When Operation Crayweed came into their sphere, it was really apparent to both board riders and SeaTrees, this would be a really great opportunity to connect all three and launch a project that was local to Australians.
My name is Laura Enever. I'm a Sydney local. I've grown up here, I learned to surf here, and I'm a professional surfer. I was on the world tour for 7 years, and yeah, I absolutely love being from Sydney.
How are you?
Hello.
Good to meet you, Ziggy.
Yeah.
I remember the crayweed, the little things used to pop them.
That's right,
when I was a kid.
Right.
Yeah.
But not anymore.
I haven't seen him for a while.
Every individual is either a male or a female. And so this one here, I don't know if you can see.
These little lumps.
Like long kind of, so that's a boy. I think that's a girl, yeah.
There we go, we have a couple. When they get a little bit of stress, the moment they get placed back in the water, they sort of like freak out. And the first thing they want to do is reproduce. So the males release sperms from each of these little lumps that you're seeing there and goes in the water column, and it fertilizes the eggs of the female on the leaves, and then once the egg is fertilized, it actually drops, and that attaches to the rock, and that creates a new crayweed. And after 3 to 6 months, you actually can see them with the naked eye. And then after a year and a half, 2 years, those guys are mature enough so they can actually reproduce themselves.
We've actually done the numbers. With $1 million, we could establish seeding kind of populations of crayweed in each one of the 23 reefs where we think it used to be.
There's not a lot to bring back the crayweed and diversity of our oceans.
Whenever we plant sites, anyone can help because the whole process involves different stages, some of which are done on land. And this is the site where we're going to be planting crayweed today. So this is a site that used to have crayweed, but disappeared back in the 80s, and we're bringing it back with the help of you guys.
From a surface point of view, there's a reflection off the water of the sky all the time. So we don't really get to see at our low level on a surfboard what's really going on underneath us. You know, until I met the scientists involved with this project, I didn't know exactly how seaweed sort of helped us regarding its sequestering of carbon so efficiently underneath the water, and the way they acted underneath the oceans to soak it up and take care of it for us.
This partnership with SeaTrees allows us to celebrate that kind of partnership for the first time, actually, which is really cool.
I think projects like this are so important. I mean, we talk about how, you know, there's all these like big scary aspects of climate change and damages happening around the world, and some of them feel so out of reach, but this project in particular, it's right here in our backyard, and it's something that is fully achievable. We could plan and regenerate the crayweed and really save what we lost. And we could do that right now, right here and with our own hands, and really achieve that goal.
Operation Crayweed's success is created by combining a deep scientific knowledge of marine ecosystems with a community's collective love for the ocean. Thanks to the scientists at the Sydney Institute of Marine Science, engaged locals, and the surfing community, there is a strong alliance ready and willing to help bring back the lost kelp forests of Sydney, Australia. Join us on our ambitious mission to rewild this beautiful coastline